With the latest KSP 1.11 release, we now have the ability to repair or even assemble parts during EVAs. I'm Onlight Metals, and today I will show you a concept of a repair vessel whose goal is to bring large amounts of gear to the other side of the cable system. By other side of the cable system, I mean going to ILU to deliver a substantial payload. The launch window planet tool developed by Alex Moon tells us about a possible transfer window to this celestial body. The departure date is around the 256th day of the second cable year. A thrust of about 2050 meters per second of delta V will be needed to get there. Once arrived, we will have to perform a 1.5 thousand meters per second of delta V break to circularize around ILU. Here are the main characteristics of our Eagle ship. The payload represents 22% of the overall mass. As you can see, we rely on hybrid ionic and chemical propulsion to travel in space. When both propulsion modes are run together, Dawn engines will provide 12.5% of the total thrust. That's not much, but far from being negligible. The VTOL engines are only used during VTOL maneuvers or to give an additional kick to the Cheetah engines on the first part of an ascent to reach orbit. Ionic engines improve the overall range of our ship but have the disadvantage of not being very punchy. Therefore, the main stages of our journey to ILU begin with a series of burns to raise our apoapsis around Kerbin. We plan to spend about 850 meters per second of delta V here. The last orbit around Kerbin will likely take between 20 to 30 Kerbin days, so we will launch our rocket 31 days before the departure date. When Dawn, we will perform our injection towards ILU with both ionic and chemical propulsion. According to the transfer window planner tool, we will have to spend 1200 meters per second of delta V for this maneuver. As ion engines provide about 12% of the total thrust, we split the amount of delta V between chemical and ion propulsions. We will likely have a mid-course correction, which will be performed with our ion engines. I budget 300 here. Yes, it's pretty high, but I prefer to overestimate what will be needed. A touchy 1.5 thousand meters per second of delta V burn is needed to circularize around ILU. This will take a long time because we will rely exclusively on Dawn engines for this maneuver. We plan to spend 300 for maneuvers in low ILU orbit in order to choose our landing site. Again, that's a lot, but I prefer to take a comfortable margin. Last, we have to land on ILU. The delta V map says 620 meters per second of delta V are needed. Again, we take a margin, but our Dawn engines will help us a little bit to kill our velocity. The final meters of our descent will be performed with our VTOL engines. To summarize these figures, the delta V capacity of our ship is just above what we need. This journey appears to be hopefully doable. Actually, I would not do this video otherwise. I quickly skipped the launch, it's not the most interesting part of the trip. Sending medium-sized ships into space does not represent any particular challenge anyway. The goal is simply to send our ship into LKO without emptying its tanks, so that all its fuel is preserved for the trip. We therefore ask our core booster to finish the circularization before sending it back to Kerbin. back to the Eagle, we are in orbit at about 182 kilometers high. Now it's time to focus on the next step, which is raising our apoapsis with ion engines. The figures you can see explain what we can actually achieve regarding our battery capacity, the number of ATGs we have on board, and the number of down engines which consumes our electricity. For the whole spreadsheet, here are the formula used. The resulting delta V according to the mass lost during a maneuver and the ISP of the engines used. The orbital period of an orbit given its semi-major axis. The orbital velocity of a circular orbit, the mechanical energy of an orbit, and the new one if we change its velocity. Regarding this first part, we have two key numbers. The first one is the time needed for complete charge of the batteries, and it is 1 hour and 20 minutes. The second one is the maximum time we can sustain an electric burn. It is about 7 minutes and a half. During this time, and being fully loaded, we can deliver 205 meters per second of delta V. That means that to deliver 850, we will have at least 5 burns. For each burn we plan to do, a margin is taken because maneuvers are not instantaneous and not 100% efficient. The step 1 calculations show that after the first burn, we won't have enough time to completely recharge our batteries. The second burn will have to be a lot shorter than the first one. What the third burn provides won't do the trick for a full burn either. It's only with the fourth burn that we can actually make it. For the fourth, fifth and sixth burn, while we could obviously do more, we focus on the resulting orbital period of the new orbit. So that, in the end, the periapsis is reached when we have to leave Kerbin for ILU. Orbits are so eccentric, we don't have to play much with the delta V spent to have a huge impact on the orbital period. For step 2, step 3, nothing is difficult here. For each step, we calculate how much mass is lost regarding the budgeted delta V. Step 4. Circularization around ILU will take a while to be performed, due to the huge quantity of velocity we need to match ILU's orbit, and as we plan to burn on ion engines only, it would normally take 40 minutes to be completed. But our battery capacity does not allow such a maneuver, we will have to burn much more longer with a smaller thrust. A 7.7 hours burn has to be done and represents quite a challenge. Step 5, nothing much to tell here, and step 6, finally we land on ILU. As the chemical propellant is the most critical resource in this journey, it is interesting to double check what we need to land. It appears we finally have much more margin than expected, and even 500 meters per second of delta V can be used to help for circularization. The next video will show the actual journey to ILU, starting with the successive burns in Kerbin orbit, unloading the payload in a creative way, then returning in LKO from ILU. We've hit the 100 subs last week, and I would like to thank you sincerely for your support. Please continue to like, comment and share the videos, so that the channel may continue to grow. Take care, and don't forget to test is to adopt.